गणपतये नमः ओम गुं गुरुभ्यो नमः ओम सरस्वत्यै नमः मंगलम श्री गुरुर् ध्यानं मंगलम तत्पदाम्बुजं मंगलम तज्जपो नित्यं मंगलम गुणकीर्तनम् मन्नाथ श्री जगन्नाथ मद्गुरु श्री जगद्गुरु ममात्मा सर्वभूतात्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नित्यशुद्धं निराभासं निराकारं निरञ्जनं नित्यबोधं चिदानन्दं गुरुं ब्रह्म नमम्यहं
दिव्य आत्मन
इन दिस वीडियो हियर इज एन हंबल अटेम्प्ट टू रीड आउट message of our worshipful Gurudev Sri Swami Chidananda Maharaj. Gurudev says, you are eternal beyond time. You are timeless. Nevertheless, even though you are rooted in that state of timelessness, you now find yourself to be a creature of times. Is there any way that we can profit from this peculiar paradoxical situation we are caught in? While we are in time, can we turn it to our advantage and utilize it in a gainful way? Our wise ancients admonished us, forget about the past. It doesn't exist. It is finished. Don't be burdened by it. But before you forget it, take from it all the lessons and wisdom it has taught you about yourself and the world. Then fully concentrate on the present. Focus upon all the opportunities it offers you each day. Take the present in both your hands in a creative, dynamic, constructive way. Be always positive. And while you thus take wisdom from the past and focus upon the opportunities of the present, visualize what you wish to be in the future. I wish to be a liberated soul. I wish to be an instrument of God and a benefactor of man. I wish to bring glory and honor to my Guru, to become an embodiment of his teachings and the teachings of the scriptures and all the great saints. In this way, utilize time to go beyond time. Attain your true status as the time transcending eternal all perfect being. Do it now and become blessed. Lord Krishna says to Arjuna, I am the indwelling principle, O Arjuna. I reside in the hearts of all beings. I am the eternal within the non-eternal. Yo mam pasyati sarvatra sarvam cha mai pasyati tasyaham na pranashyami sa cha me na pranashyati. He who sees me everywhere and sees everything in me, he never becomes separated from me, nor do I become separated from him. These are all direct assertions. There is no intricate philosophy, no concealed or indirect meaning. No one can fail to easily grasp the great truth proclaimed. The central fact of God and his creation, which has been declared so that you can make it the basis of your view of life. Why is it that though this truth is being read 1,000 times, we still do not succeed in maintaining this vision? The answer to this question is given right at the beginning of the 11th chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna, it is subtler than the subtlest of all beings. You are vision is gross? Why is my vision gross? This is the unasked question of Arjuna. Your vision is gross because you perceive through a heart where there is not the purity of subtlety or the subtlety of purity. Your vision is gross because you perceive and interpret through a mind which itself is gross, is not pure, sattvic, spiritual, is not divine. Purity has not been consciously cultivated. If the heart and mind are pure, you will see me. When the heart is pure and filled with light, God is perceived everywhere through human sight. God dwells in a pure heart and mind. Therefore, make yourself radiantly pure, immaculate. That is the key, that is the secret. Hari Om Tat Sat.